also commonly known as the coronavirus. We have found it necessary to convene this press conference to enlighten the nation on its effects, particularly from an agriculture perspective. First and foremost, I would like to reiterate the statements that have already been made to the effect that this is a deadly disease that spreads very fast through contact with droplets from infected persons. It is therefore important to take the necessary precautions to protect ourselves from contracting the virus as advised by the Ministry of Health. We can only be able to achieve this through cooperative action and adherence to advice from experts and government pronouncements such as the partial lockdown. The pandemic has negative effects on the global economic performance that trickles down to individual countries. It has led to restricted movements of people and goods, which are the main drivers of an economy. We have seen self-isolation of workers, closure of ports of entry, and lockdowns. The country has announced a partial lockdown. The demand for food, while in that situation, will remain high, and it is our responsibility as a sector to facilitate its availability and also ensure that it is safe to consume. It is in this regard that as a sector, we have come up with short, medium, and long-term strategies to ensure that Emaswati continue to have food during these trying times. The agriculture sector plays a pivotal role in the survival of the human race, and as such, proactive action is required to curb the effects of the COVID-19 that is currently a problem in the whole world. The Kingdom of Eswatini is no exception. The country is heavily dependent on imports for food supply, and it is envisaged that the flow of goods into the country will be affected by the control measures that have been put in place at ports of entry, as well as competition with other countries as the demand for food is expected to grow. We equally depend on imports for inputs that we use in our production systems for both crops and livestock. We anticipate that this will affect our production potential. We are observing that retail prices of both food items and inputs are increasing at an alarming rate, which is regrettably not supported. This can be attributed to many factors, such as reduced production due to closure of farms and industries, reduced distribution of food supply countrywide, and challenges with movements of goods across borders, including imports and exports, among others. Mitigation strategies in the short term. One, stocking up and distribution. As an immediate measure, we have instructed all importers of critical grains to stock up sufficient volumes. We are requesting community leaders, including Tingunla structures, to indicate shortages of basic food items in their communities so that we can facilitate availability. We also encourage those who have food commodities to use them sparingly and practice barter trade with those in need. Communities are further encouraged to trade amongst themselves for a fair distribution of food. Two, harvesting, storage, and food utilization. As we approach the harvesting season, it is important that good care is taken to minimize post-harvest losses. This can be achieved through timely harvesting and proper storage of produce. Proceeds from the sale of produce should be spent on necessary items to serve the future expenses. The ministry has information on various food preservation methods that can prolong the shelf life of food commodities. This can be practiced at household level. They include drying, canning, bottling, and freezing. The nation is urged to seriously consider these preservation methods as a means to ensure food availability. Proper food preparation and self-consumption of food is also an important element to minimize cases of opportunistic infections and nutritional deficiencies. Kettle dipping is a mandatory activity enforced by law. The purpose is to minimize the spread of animal diseases. However, during the lockdown period, farmers are hereby informed that dipping will be suspended. Veterinary assistants will be available to assist farmers with their needs. Mitigation strategies in the medium to long term. To sustain our food system in the medium to long term, the Ministry of Agriculture has prioritized the critical commodities needed for the country to be able to sustain itself, to include maize, beans, vegetables, beef, poultry, pork, and milk. The country has looked at interventions to address shortages in the above-mentioned commodities, and a series of interventions have been put in place, and these include the following. A, farmers are being encouraged to produce as much grain as possible, and NMC has been directed and capacitated to buy them at a competitive price. B, an intensive mobilization program will be pursued to help farmers produce the required volumes to satisfy the market. C, through irrigated farming, farmers will be encouraged to also produce all the critical crops during winter season to ensure year-round production. D, as a country, we will be investing on local processing of food items. A good example is what will shortly be happening in the dairy industry, where we are completing a processing facility that will ensure that all milk produced in the country will be absorbed and processed for both local and export market. E, in recognition of the need to absorb additional milk from farmers, the ministry is in the process of establishing milk collection centers in communities to ensure ease of collection to the processing plant. F, several farms have been identified and dedicated to the breeding of dairy animals to reduce dependence on imports, especially during disease outbreaks in the countries from which we import cows. G, on poultry, we are engaging with potential investors for the development of a breeding plant that will ensure the supply of fertile eggs and day-old chicks for our farmers, which is a measure to reduce dependence on imports. H, in regard to vegetables, there will be capacitation of nurseries to supply seedlings throughout the year, stocking up of seed material for direct planting that will meet the increased demand, as well as ensuring a coordinated market-led program. Undercover production will also be promoted to increase productivity on different types of vegetables. The COVID-19 pandemic is a catastrophe that threatens the survival of our country. On the other hand, we should look at it as a wake-up call that tells us that we need to pull up our sleeves and produce our own food and reduce dependency on imports. Let us only import what cannot be produced in our soil and climatic conditions. I therefore request all Emaswati to take this challenge positively and embark on food production for both local and international markets. We should reach a situation where our exports are more than imports, and we should take advantage of our comparative and competitive advantages. I thank you.